Well, most people would probably agree that adding cheese to a recipe does make it much better. And today, cookbook author and chef Sabrina Tutino is going to prove that theory with a decadent recipe for meatloaf. Thanks for coming in. It's the first time that I have the opportunity to work with you.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
It's a pleasure. Home is Quebec. Oui, Montreal?
Yes, Montreal.
Montreal. Okay, yeah. Well, bienvenue.
Merci, merci beaucoup.
Okay, so we're making, this is a special, what's the name of the meatloaf?
This is a meatloaf with an Italian twist, okay? Because I'm using Italian products such as prosciutto, tomato, a little vino, and the mozzarella cheese, which I love.
Okay, but there are different types of mozzarella cheese, right?
Yes, this one is typical for cooking because it melts and it stretches. It's very important to use this kind of mozzarella if you want that delicious effect, the yummy stretch.
Okay, so how do we start? What do we do?
Okay, so in a bowl, I mixed my meat. This is pork, okay? I put an egg, salt, and pepper, and now I put it in an oven-proof dish with a plastic wrap under, because we're going to have to roll it, okay?
I see. Okay.
So I'm going to take some tomato. You're going to see it's easy and it's delicious. It's the mozzarella gives it like the gourmet touch to this recipe.
But specifically the mozzarella, right? Mm-hmm. You wouldn't want to use another cheese with this?
You could, but you're not going to have the stretch.
Yeah, I hear you.
You know, that's the whole point. It's when it's hot, you cut it and you see and the
exactly. Yeah.
So this is the whole, so I'm cut up some onions. I'm gonna spread some onions. Just make sure you spread it equally.
Can it be red onions, sweet onions?
Yes, what anything onion? You want. Okay. You could even stuff it with whatever you want. This is just my way of doing it and it's delicious. And this is broth powder. It gives that extra.
What kind of powder?
Broth.
So beef broth, chicken broth?
Anything you want.
Anything you want,
yes. It replaces the salt and pepper and it gives it that extra taste.
You're Italian, right?
Yes.
Yeah, Tutino.
Yes, my parents are. I was born in Canada. So here's the
prosciutto.
Prosciutto.
What part of Italy are they from?
Sicily.
Ah, the south.
The south, it's
Calabrese?
Beautiful.
Calabrese or Bruzzese?
No, Siciliana.
Oh, Siciliana.
Sicily.
What am I talking about, of course.
And now I'm going to put the cheese. This is the magic.
En français, c'est la pièce de résistance, oui.
C'est exactement. Vous parlez très bien français,
merci
monsieur.
Merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup.
Okay, now it's time to roll it up. I could add a little olive oil.
What kind of olive oil? Virgin olive oil?
Yeah.
Yeah. And don't forget the vino.
That's at the end.
Oh, that's after?
Yeah.
So this is a crafty way of
rolling up.
I see.
See?
Wow, with the saran.
Yes, it's the easy way. Of doing stuff. So you could roll it. And it doesn't matter if, you know, it's not perfect. You could just roll it up like this. Oh, it gets stuck. Yeah. Like this.
That's what I'm here
and
for.
Just roll it up.
Yeah.
Oop.
Okay,
oh,
that's
I messed
okay.
it up.
Oh. Okay. And you want to press it, right? So it sticks together.
But you could use your hands.
Sure, yeah,
exactly.
Oh, well, look at that.
There you go. And it doesn't matter.
Like
stuff is going to come out. It's the whole point. It's very homey, and then you just garnish it with whatever you want.
Okay, and you have a few other things here in terms of presentation as well, yeah?
Yes.
Is this the finished product over here?
Yes.
Well, let's look at that.
There you go.
This is what it looks like when it's done. I'll just put this on the table.
So the recipe, I think, is going to be on your website, so
it will
everybody's going to have more
Same with the link
detail.
To your cookbook.
Exactly.
And very quickly, show us other forms of presentation for this.
This is a leftover meatloaf. It's cold. And you can put it in a sandwich or a salad. It's delicious.
It's a sandwich.
Yes. This is the portobello mushroom pizza without a dough. So it's perfect.
Yeah,
it's carb-free with mozzarella on top.
And
it's
what's
perfect
inside
for appetizer. Tomato, spinach, and olive tapenade.
Nice.
Okay. And this is a seared scallop with caramelized onions and fig jam covered with mozzarella.
And all of these, are all of these in your latest cookbook?
Some of it, but you could go on saputo.ca and you could find all the recipes there.
Okay, Sabrina, thank you very much
thank
for coming
you
in.
So
and we have
much.
Links to all of Sabrina's recipes that we've shown you here today on our website. Just click on to news links.
Thank you so much.
Oh, it was a pleasure.